Hello scholars, I am Amita More, your science educator. Today we are going to start with our second topic, rocks and minerals. Scholars, earth is almost made up of rocks. Why is it so? Because when we see hills, mountains, valleys, they are made up of rocks. Even the stones and pebbles, they are made up of rocks. Even the soil, sand, they are made up of very fine particles of the rocks. These rocks are of various sizes, shapes and of various texture. So from where they have come, how these rocks are formed and what are the various types of rocks, that we are going to learn in this topic. What are the various minerals and how they are related with the rocks and its uses, that also we are going to learn in this topic. So scholars, let's start with our topic, rocks and minerals. So scholars, let's start with the topic, rocks and minerals. Before that, I would like to ask you one question. On which planet do we live? Yes, we live on the planet called Earth. There are 8 planets in our solar system, and those planets are Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. But there is life only on Earth, is it? So, when we talk about Earth, we see the soil, the rocks on the Earth. And here is a picture of some rocks. So, when we see the Earth, okay, it is just blue in color, is it? You might have seen in the globe as well. Why? Because most of the surface of the Earth is covered with water. And the remaining one is covered with the soil. But how actually the earth inside, that we are going to see with the help of the diagram. The layers of the earth. Now, our earth is made up of rocks and minerals in different layers. There are 3 layers of the earth. The first one is the crust, second mantle and third core. Let's talk about these layers of earth in detail. Crust. The crust is outer hard part of the earth. This crust is mostly covered by sand, soil, water and ice. So scholars, when we are walking, we are actually walking on the crust. Second is mantle. Below this crust, there is the layer called mantle, and almost 80% of the earth is formed by this mantle. And the third one is core. Core is the innermost layer of the earth, but it is divided into 2 parts, inner core and outer core. The inner core is hard like a ball and it is made up of iron and nickel. Whereas the outer core is extremely hot. You can see in the diagram, it is yellow in color. The outer core is extremely hot and is made up of metal. So, there are 3 layers of the earth. Outermost is the crust, middle one is the mantle, and innermost is the core. Now students, if we compare the layers of the earth with the egg, we can come to this point. See, we know that the birds lay the eggs and then the baby comes out from that egg. Fine. So, if we compare the egg with the layers of the earth, the outermost covering of the egg, which is hard, is called as the eggshell. Inside that there is the fluid called albumen, and innermost part of the egg is called as egg yolk. So if we compare the egg with the layers of the earth, we can say that our earth is like the egg only. The outermost eggshell, we call it as crust, which is hard. Inside crust there is mantle, and then the innermost is the core. here are some pictures. Okay, there is a picture of Taj Mahal. Now, what is this first picture that you have to find by yourself? Then there is one building. Fine, there is the floor. So all these pictures are showing us how much rocks are useful to us. So how do we classify these rocks, and what are the three types of rocks that we are going to see in further slides? There are three types of rocks. From that, the first one is igneous rocks. Here is a picture of volcanic eruption, and you can see that the magma, which is yellow in color, is coming out of that volcano. Okay, and it just flowing like a river. Okay, so when this magma, it cools down, it becomes igneous rock. So when a volcano erupts, magma flows out as lava, and when this magma cools down and it hardens, it forms the igneous rock. So we can say that igneous rocks are the fire made rocks. Now, what are their characteristics? They are glossy, shiny, they are smooth, and they are colored one. The examples of igneous rocks are granite, obsidian, pumice, and basalt. Now, let's see what are the uses of these igneous rocks one by one. Granite. Granite is used for the construction of front parts of the building, even kitchen tops and for table tops. You can see in the first picture, there is a kitchen top made up of granite. The second one is pumice. Pumice, it is used for the scrubbing or removing dead skin. You might have seen this pumice in the bathroom, and it is also used for making the lightweight construction material because it is the lightweight. Third one is the basalt. It is used for building roads. And the fourth one is obsidian, which is very colorful and beautiful. It is used for making the ornament. So these are the four types of igneous rocks. Let's see the second type of rock. Second type of rocks is sedimentary rocks. Now let's see what are the sediments. Sediments means the layers. Because of wind, rain, the rocks, they break into small pieces, and along with wind and rain, they just flow to the lakes, rivers and seas. There they sink into the bottom and they form layer one upon another called sediments. So when the sand, pebbles and other sediments they collect, they form the sedimentary rocks. But there are two different ways forming the sedimentary rocks. The first one, when the sediments of the sand and pebbles deposit as layer one on top of the other and tightly pressed together. And second, when the sediments are cemented together by minerals found in water. So what are the examples of sedimentary rocks that we will see in the next slide? So scholars, here are the example of sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks, the first one is limestone. Limestone, it is a soft rock and is made up of mineral like calcium. It is used as a building stone as well in the production of lime, paint and cement. The chalk that we used for writing, it is also a form of limestone. Second example of sedimentary rock is conglomerate, which is also called as a pudding stone. Why pudding? Because it is looking like pudding. It is made up of rounded pebbles and coarse gravel. They are together by minerals into a solid mass. It is used as a building material. The third example is sandstone. Do you remember the red fort? Now, the red fort is made up of the sandstone. It is also used as a building material. Red fort, Agra fort and many other monuments are made up of sandstone. And the fourth example of sedimentary rocks is shell, which is also called as the mudstone. It is used in making bricks and for constructing roads. Students, in next video, we will learn about the third type of rocks, that is metamorphic rocks as well. What are the minerals and what are their uses? Thank you.